Chapter 21. Flight through the five passes. With the help of Huang Feihu, Prince Wen secretly left Jiaoga and crossed the Yellow River on the same night. He made his way through Miangchi County towards Lingtong Pass. At the hostel, the officials became extremely anxious when he failed to return all night. They hurriedly reported the situation to Fei Zhong. "What shall I do now? If I'm held responsible, it could cause me a lot of trouble." Fei Zhong hesitated as he got the news, and then immediately sent for Yu Hun to discuss the matter. When Yu Hun arrived, he told him of the situation. "On your recommendation, His Majesty created Ji Cheng Prince. As a special favor, he was also permitted to parade through the streets for 3 days. But yesterday, on only the second day, he ran away without the permission of His Majesty. He's obviously up to no good. This is really serious. We're already trying to cope with the South and East, and now his flight may mean another crisis. Who's going to assume responsibility? What shall we do?" Fei Zhong asked. "Don't worry, brother. I don't think this is any trouble. Let's talk to His Majesty and advise him to send men after Ji Cheng. When he's brought back, we'll behead him in the market for insulting the king. We've got nothing to worry about." Reaching agreement on the matter, Fei Zhong and Yu Hun went to see King Zhou at the star-picking mansion. "What do you have to report to me, ministers? We must inform your majesty that Ji Chang's so ungrateful that he's disobeyed your orders and stealthily ran away on just the second day of his celebratory parade. He's likely to rebel after returning to his dukedom. We wrongly recommended him and must assume responsibility for it. We await your decision." They reported carefully. King Zhou was infuriated. "It's only on your recommendations that I decided to pardon him. What's happened today is entirely your responsibility. Human hearts have never been easy to fathom. A man may appear obedient, yet nurses treachery in his heart. As the saying goes, when the sea dries up one can see the bottom, but not even when a man dies can one know his heart. Ji Cheng can't have gotten very far. Your majesty may send generals Ying Po Bai and Lei Kai after him. When they bring him back, deal with him according to the law," Yu Hun suggested. King Zhou gave his immediate approval, and in no time at all, generals Ying and Lei, leading 3,000 hand-picked cavalrymen, left the west gate in hot pursuit. Prince Wen, meanwhile, was taking his time. He was riding leisurely through Miangchi County when he heard the sudden clamor of men and horses behind him. Looking back, he saw a trail of dust rising in the air, and realizing that the king's men were after him, he was terrified. He gazed at the heavens. "Though Prince Huang was kind to me, I've been careless. The king's bound to find out that I've fled the capital and has sent troops after me. If I'm caught this time, I'll be a dead man. All I can do is ride as fast as I can and try to escape danger." He quickly decided. He galloped wildly, not knowing where he was going. He cried out to heaven for help, but there was no response. He appealed to the earth, but the earth was silent. At about 20 li from Lingtong Pass, the pursuing troops were almost upon him. Prince Wen was in a critical situation. But now let's return to Master of the Clouds, who was just then meditating on his green touring bed. All of a sudden he felt a surge of uneasiness pass through him, and he quickly made a divination on his fingers. "Oh," he exclaimed. "The West Grand Dukes escaped one calamity only to run into another. I must fulfill the promise I made on Mount Yan and allow father and son to meet again today," he told himself, then shouted. "Where are you, Golden Haze lad? Go to the peach garden and bring Thunderbolt here at once." Thunderbolt came and knelt before him. "I await your instructions, master." "Disciple. Disaster is about to befall your father. You'd better go and rescue him." "Who's my father?" "Ji Cheng, the West Grand Duke. He's facing danger now near Lingtong Pass. You'd better go to the Tiger Cliff and find yourself a weapon. I'll teach you how to handle it so that you can go to his rescue." On these orders, Thunderbolt left the Jade Pillar Cave and went straight to the Tiger Cliff. He looked all around, but could not find anything that looked like a weapon. I was careless not to have asked my master for more details. I've heard that there are many kinds of weapons, like spears, cutlasses, swords, halberds, whips, axes, and hammers, but I don't know which kind my master meant. I'd better go back and ask him. As he turned to go, an exotic fragrance suddenly filled his nostrils. He followed the scent and found a stream rushing down a hillside of exquisite beauty. Creepers entwined cypress and pine trees and swaying bamboos covered the slopes. Foxes and hares ran about freely. Deer and cranes wandered amongst the trees. Fairy mushrooms peeped out from behind green grass, and tree branches bowed low under the weight of juicy plums. Although drunk with this lovely scene, he noticed two beautiful red apricots hanging on a leafy bough. The sight filled him with delight, and regardless of danger, he struggled up the steep slope clinging to vines and creepers to pick the fruit. He was tempted by the exotic fragrance. "I'll eat one of them and take the other to my master," he decided. But he found the first so delicious that he couldn't resist eating the other as well. He devoured them both. He was going to resume his search for a weapon when there was a sudden explosion. A long wing grew from under his left armpit and hung to the ground. "Oh, woe is me! What shall I do now?" he cried in terror. He was trying to rip the wing off when another one sprang out from under his right arm. At a total loss what to do, he sank to the ground. What terrified him most was not the wings, but that his whole body had been transformed. His nose had grown high, his face had turned indigo, his hair had turned red, his eyes had become swollen balls, his teeth had become tusks, and his trunk had grown 20 feet tall. As he sat stupefied, Golden Haze Lad came up and called to him. "Brother, Master orders you to return at once." "Look at me, brother. How can I go and see him like this?" Thunderbolt said despondently. But Golden Haze Lad shouted, "You'd better come quickly. Master's waiting for you." Thunderbolt walked back dejectedly, feeling ugly and awkward, his two long wings dragging on the ground like a defeated cock. Master of the Clouds was standing outside the cave. When he saw Thunderbolt, he clapped his hands, exclaiming, "How wonderful! How wonderful!" And then ordered, "Come with me." Thunderbolt followed him into the peach garden. The Taoist took up a golden cudgel, handed it to him, and taught him how to use it. He learned to whirl it until it whistled like the wind, to advance and retreat like a darting serpent, to turn like a savage tiger, and to rise like a dragon from the sea. The whirling cudgel filled the air with bright light, and at its flying tip formed beautiful brocades and myriads of dancing flowers. As soon as Thunderbolt had thoroughly mastered the weapon, Master of the Clouds wrote, "Wind" on his left wing and "Thunder" on his right. And when he muttered a magic charm, Thunderbolt spread his wings and soared high into the sky, the beating of his wings producing a roar like thunder. Dropping back down to the ground, Thunderbolt knelt before Master of the Clouds and thanked him, saying, "Master, I'm so grateful to you for passing on such miraculous skills to me and enabling me to rescue my father. You couldn't have shown me greater kindness. You'd better go to Lingtong Pass now and rescue your father," replied Master of the Clouds. "Go quickly and return without delay. You may escort your father through the five passes, but you're not permitted to go to West Qi with him. Neither may you hurt any general or soldier. After fulfilling this mission, you must return to Mount Zhongnan at once and continue to cultivate yourself with me. I'll let you meet your brothers in the near future." Thunderbolt left the Jade Pillar Cave on wing and reached Lingtong Pass in the twinkling of an eye. Alighting on a peak, he looked around carefully, but could not see any sign of his father. "I was really careless not to have asked my master what my father looks like. How am I going to recognize him?" he wondered. Just then, a man in a black shirt and green felt hat galloped swiftly towards him on a white horse. "Is that the West Grand Duke at the foot of the hill?" he shouted. Hearing a voice, Prince Wan reined in his horse and looked up, but could see no one. He sighed to himself. My life's nearly over. Why else would I hear a voice, yet see no one? It must be a ghost or a devil fooling with me. Since Thunderbolt had a blue face and green body, he blended in with the colors of the mountain, so Prince Wan could not see him at a distance. Thunderbolt saw the man stop his horse, look around, and then continue on his way. Is that His Highness the West Grand Duke Ji Chang? He shouted again. Prince Wan lifted his head again, and when he caught sight of Thunderbolt's indigo face and red hair, he was scared out of his wits. If he were a ghost, he wouldn't be able to speak. Since I've no way to evade him, I may as well climb the mountain and find out who he is. He reasoned and urged his horse up the mountain. Who's that hero? How do you know my name? He asked in return. Hearing his words, Thunderbolt fell to the ground and kowtowed. Forgive me, father. I've arrived late and caused you great alarm. You're wrong, hero. I've never met you before. Why do you call me father? I'm Thunderbolt, you adopted me on Mount Yan 7 years ago. My son, how is it that you've grown up to look like this? It's been exactly 7 years since Master of the Clouds took you into his care. How did you come here today? By order of my master, I've come here to help you out of trouble. I'll escort you through the five passes and repel the soldiers for you. I fled the capital and have committed a crime against King Zhou. Prince Wan thought. This chap looks pretty rough. If he kills anyone, my crime will become much more serious. I must convince him not to use violence. Thunderbolt, my dear boy. You must be careful not to hurt the generals or soldiers. I fled Zhaoge, expressing gross ingratitude towards His Majesty. Should you hurt any of them, you wouldn't be saving my life, but would place me in a much worse situation. Don't worry, father. Thunderbolt assured him. My master also instructed me not to hurt any of King Zhou's men. My duty is to rescue you, take you through the five passes, and then go straight back to the mountain. I'll go now and persuade the troops to return to Zhaoge in peace. Thunderbolt discovered that the pursuing troops were close upon them. Their flags fluttered bravely in the air, drums and gongs sounded noisily, and dust filled the sky, blocking out the sun. With a flap of his wings, Thunderbolt soared into the sky, brandishing his cudgel. Prince Wan was so shocked that he tumbled to the ground. Thunderbolt circled up into the sky and landed right in front of the soldiers. He stood the golden cudgel on the palm of his hand and roared. Don't you dare come any further. The soldiers were astonished to see him and rushed back to Yin Po Bai and Lei Kai crying. There's an evil god blocking the path ahead. He looks a ferocious, brutal fellow. Ying and Lei angrily ordered them away, and spurring their horses forward, advanced to engage Thunderbolt. What became of them? If you want to know, you must read the next chapter.